If you ever discovered discrepancies between your RTK drone data and your GCPs, this might be a very good and helpful tutorial for you. You will learn how to move or shift all the coordinates of the EXIF JPEG information to match your GCPs. This workflow is working for any devices which stores the EXIF information, so the coordinates, directly into the JPEG files. My name is Hans and I will guide you through this video tutorial. So there's one main source of error, and this is the transformation between your drone coordinate system, WGS84, and your local coordinate system, where you usually record your GCPs with the GNSS receiver and your total station. So the transformation between those can vary. Your local GNSS receiver tachymeter will use more sophisticated transformation, whereas your photogrammetry software might use a very rough one. So what's causing the errors now? There are several issues we can correct, others we can't. The first one is if the auto-calibration during the orientation process fails, so if you get a wrong focal length, for example, then you will determine an error on your GCPs, but you have to pre-calibrate the camera actually to correct this. The second one are mostly if you have a lot of trees or water bodies on the images, then some images might be not well orientated. And if you discover an RTK loss or float or a single solution only, you might have to perform the flight again or use traditional GCPs to do the photogrammetric processing. On the other hand, there are several errors which I can correct in Redtoolbox very easily. For example, if you set up your base station in the field and entered the wrong coordinate or even no coordinate, then the whole flight will be shifted. This will result in a misalignment between the GCPs and the RTK data. So we can correct this by shifting the coordinates of the images in Redtoolbox. You might check if your conversation between WGS84 and your local coordinate system is accurate or not. Visit the epsg.io website to check if your EPSG code has security problems, and if so, you can shift it. And the third thing is if you expect the error only vertical, then you might apply the wrong or even no GWID information, and then you can bulk shift the whole bundle block vertically to match your GCPs. There are limits. You can't shift by a couple of kilometers, so only a few meters are allowed. And if you have a large survey area and the GWID will change, you might run into troubles because we can only shift a constant value in height. So apply shifts only within a small area, and apply the shift only if you're sure it's a shift and not a mathematical transformation, so a rotation or something else. Yeah, be aware of this. So let's apply a shift on a drone project. First, I will orient all the images in photogrammetry software, load a GCP, assign it in the images, and determine the offset in X, Y, and Z. Second, I will start Redtoolbox software and load all the images into the software. I will enter the inverted offset and apply this transformation. This will result in a text file, which I then can load in photogrammetry software again and update the image coordinates to match the GCPs. So let's open Agisoft as a photogrammetry software. I've loaded the images, aligned them, and clicked one GCP in the images. In Agisoft, I will deselect the marker to show the correct value offset. So the error is only displayed. If you ticked it, it's a kind of a preview, accuracy preview. So we have 1.7 meters in altitude, almost 1 meter and 15 centimeters in northing. Okay, with this information, we will start Redtoolbox now. So Redtoolbox, in version 3.9, there are two main workflows. One is the shift EXIF coordinate workflow. First, we will select the image folder so the software can read all the coordinates from each image. I'm choosing text file as output, so I can re-import and override the coordinates afterwards. And I'm choosing the inverted errors from photogrammetry software in the third column, so in the transformation triple. There are negative values displayed in photogrammetry in Agisoft for this GCP, so I'm entering the opposite values, so in the positive direction for this case. After this, simply click Create Output, and a folder next to the images will be created where this text file is saved. Back in Agisoft, you can import this text file. So I'm going to locate it. So image folder, this is the new subfolder created, and the raw text file. Choose the right columns to import it. WGS84 as coordinate system. And you see that the new coordinates will be applied to the JPEG files. Okay. There is a none for the GCPs now, because every time you import new coordinates, Agisoft is mixing up or messing up the coordinates. You have to rearrange the coordinate system for the markers, for the camera, and for the project. Hit OK, and you will see that the first GCP is now matched perfectly. You can check by selecting or clicking, marking the other GCPs in the project on the other images and see how big the errors will be. Well, this is a bit of a difficult GCP, so let's use another one. Yeah, okay. And afterwards, again, deselect it to display the real error and to show the real error assessment, which is really perfect. So we shifted the RTK images to match the GCPs perfect. You see, Redtoolbox is a very, very straightforward tool to bulk shift the coordinates, the RTK coordinates, from a folder which contains lots of JPEG files. And with this workflow, you can match your GCPs. You can correct some of the sources which might result these errors. Not all, be aware of this. It's best to check with your own data. So there is a 2-week trial version available on our website. And if you have any questions or need a small training or any suggestions for us, please let us know. All the best, have a nice day, bye.